Good morning, guys. It is currently 8 a.m. in America's favorite city, New Haven, Connecticut. For those of you that don't know, my name is Josh Beasley, and I'm currently a sophomore at Yale studying electrical engineering and computer science. I've been wanting to make a video about my whole mindset when it comes to productivity for a while now, but I just didn't know the right way to go about doing that. So that's what today's video is about. So rather than sitting in front of a camera for 10 minutes and talking, I decided I would take you along for a day in my life and show you how I fight unproductivity on a daily basis. So with that, welcome to a productive day in my life at Yale University. Porch light, mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights. I'ma need a second. Woo. All this liquor got me second guessing. Yeah. Now we 5 shots deep. Now we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots deep. I'ma need a second. Woo. So one of the first things I do every single morning when I roll out of bed is to rep out as many push-ups as I can, because you guys know I'm on that Air Force ROTC grind.
God will PT you all until you f***ing die! I'll PT you until you-
Gotta max that PT test. Anyways, then I go over to my desk, I grab my goal cards, I just have my goals written down on some index cards. I read those every single morning to kind of reaffirm what my big, like, long-term goals are for the year or the month or whatever it is, and so I can go out during that day and kind of work towards those. I talked about that in one of my previous videos on goal setting, if you wanna go check that out in a little more in depth. In addition to the goal cards, every night before I go to bed, I write down a to-do list of things I need to get done for the next day, so I can wake up and read that as well, and I have a very, like, focused idea of the specific tasks I have to accomplish for the day. So, like, here we go, is for today, the 22nd, I need to finish number 3 and number 4 of my Algos PSET. Make sure to push the latest updates of Vesta to GitLab, that's for my student dev job. I need to start my AI PSET. I need to send an email about ROTC summer programs. And then I normally have, like, a fun little to-do thing at the end, and that is have a conversation with someone I've never met before. So hopefully we can get all of these done today, that'd be pretty sick. Oh, and in addition to the actual to-do list itself, I don't let myself touch my phone at all until I have finished at least one thing on that to-do list. So right now I think I'm going to send an email about some summer programs real quick. If you're wondering where I got this idea, I highly recommend checking out Admiral William McRaven, and specifically his book, Make Your Bed. McRaven was a Navy SEAL. He was also a very successful naval officer. And the whole gist of the book is that every single day, you should start your day with a task. If you wake up every morning and you accomplish a task as the first thing you do, this energy that of accomplishing the task is going to carry with you throughout your entire day and lead to way more productivity. This can be as simple as, you know, sending an email or even making your bed, which I realize that I have not done yet. There we go. After completing my first task, I normally like to go hit the gym. I really like working out in the mornings, just getting out of the way as early as I can and feeling good for the rest of the day. That's what I normally do, but today I had to wake up super early to get all these shots for this video. So unfortunately, I'm not going to hit the gym today. Maybe I'll go later tonight. So now it is actually time to head to class. Get in there. All right. So I actually have a pretty long walk to my first class of the day, which is artificial intelligence, CS470 here at Yale. But that's good because it brings me to my next point. If you're not walking with anyone, if you're not having a conversation, I highly recommend making the most of your walks to class or across campus for any reason, because it's free time that you can use to your advantage. I normally pop in some earbuds and turn on a podcast or maybe an audiobook. Currently I'm listening to Algorithms to Live by Brian Christian and Tom Griffiths. I can't even talk today. Anyways, it's a really cool book. It takes all these big, like, famous computer science algorithms and compares them to kind of the human condition and how we live our daily lives. And it's really interesting. It's really kind of cool to take a look at computer science from kind of the perspective of, like, humanity, if that means anything. Oh, important point. Forgot to mention that you're probably going to need AirPods to do this. because if people don't know that you're listening to an audiobook or podcast and enlightening your mind as you're walking across campus, there's really no point in doing it. Now it seems like they never believed in me. So AI was super interesting today. We actually had a guest lecture from somebody who works at the Naval Research Lab about building robots that can actually fight fires on like naval cruise ships, which is like absolutely insane. One of the coolest lectures I've seen. I'm on my way to Digital Systems, which is a cool class, kind of like a crash course in like embedded systems and low-level stuff. So let's head there. Might be a mess, but this is my life. I don't wanna hear none of your bullshit. I'm doing just fine. I'ma get loose. You're feeling just a little of time. I might pass out on a lawn outside, but it's alright. Oh, 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 I'm wasted, I'm wasted. They gon' talk trash, nah, nah, nah. But that don't change facts, nah, nah, nah. So, just got back from Digital Systems and lunch. Digital Systems definitely has to be one of my favorite classes this semester. It is just so well taught and the content is so interesting. It's like very, very low level stuff. Like today we're talking about concurrence, like how do you run two parallel programs at the same time with shared variables and like maintaining atomicity and like mutual exclusion and stuff. Really, really cool stuff. A little bit complicated, but hopefully we'll be all right. I also wanted to mention lunch. I normally like to take my time with meals, get meals with people I enjoy eating with and have good conversations and really let that be a break in my day. Really, like if I have that break for lunch and I have the time eating with other people and just getting like a solid 30, 45 minutes just to relax, then I can get back to the grind of the rest of the day, right? So it helps with my productivity a lot. I have a little bit of a break in my schedule, so I have like 5-10 minutes to relax before I'm gonna head down to the TD Butter to get some work done with some friends. So it wouldn't be a Josh Beasley Day in the Life video without a little bit of magic. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you. Studying in the Buttery, I was doing a little bit of a artificial intelligence piece set, and it is quite the grind. Still having a lot of trouble passing all my test cases. Obviously though, my next big tip for productivity is, as you guys saw, I was not working alone. I was actually working with other people. Although sometimes doing computer science piece sets, you can find yourself in solidarity a lot because you're not allowed to look at each other's code. That doesn't mean you can't talk through the problems with each other and try to find a best solution and then go write the code on your own, which is something that I find very helpful. I'm actually getting dinner with the group of friends that I spent the summer in Paris with. We studied abroad together and it's been a while since we've had a meal together, so I'm kind of excited. So I'm headed to Davenport College, which is quite a trek. But, you know, maybe I'll get some cinematic footage along the way. So, it'll be a good time. Hey, maybe even they have some tips for productivity, because I'm kind of running out of ideas here. All right, we're walking over to Depot right now. Nahom, you have any tips for productivity?
There's no such thing as productivity as a STEM major, because you can't do all your work by yourself.
This might be facts. Working together is key, right, Mitch?
Oh, yeah. It's really the only way to get things done here.
This I'll remember.
So tip number one, 15. Okay, for being productive. Go to office hours. Sometimes your TA is in a really, really good mood and they will help you fix everything that's wrong with your essay. And by everything, I mean literally every sentence was wrong. And you fix them all for me. So go to office hours.
Huge move. Anything, Lauren?
Go to bed, because the more tired you are, the gears just really churn down. Stop working.
Or go. Drink coffee.
That's true. Or Diet Coke.
Oh, yeah.
Anything on that?
start early.
There we go. Especially on those CSP sets.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Dinner was great. Great to catch up with all the old friends from Paris. I'm actually on my way to my job right now. I have a shift from 6 to 9 as a... Speaking of my job and work and productivity and all that, I actually want to give a quick shout out to the sponsor of this video, Crimson Education. If you've been watching my channel for a while now, I guarantee you've seen at least one of Crimson's videos that have the goal of helping kids get into their dream school. If you're in the college application process right now or are curious about looking at schools like Yale, I highly recommend checking them out because they'll set you up with a team of strategists, mentors, tutors, whatever you need to help craft a successful college application. Whether this be SAT prep and tutoring, college essay editing, or even like extracurricular help. The best part is that it actually works, and they've had over 460 offers to top 50 colleges just since 2015. And if you're an international student, don't worry, they have over 25 offices across the globe. So if you've ever felt lost in your college applications or just feel like the competition is so intense these days, highly recommend checking Crimson out. They'll do a great job creating a successful college application and hopefully help you get in your dream school. Link down in the description below. Back to the video. Student developer for Yale, which I've talked about a little bit, but it's time to write some code. Work was good. It's definitely a long shift, but we're trying to get ready for the big release of the web app we're working on right now, which is actually going to be used to handle all of Yale's housing for this coming up housing draw, which is absolutely wild, but very busy. Right now, I'm on my way to Pearson College, which is where my buddy Tommy lives. As you guys know, I am in Timothy Dwight. That's my residential college. Tommy is in Pearson, and hopefully we're gonna grind out the rest of this algorithms piece set because it's a long one and it's due tomorrow at 2:30 p.m. Good old Pearson basement. Way nicer than TD's. Alright guys, it is now the next day. Sorry I did not keep filming that last night. I really had to finish that piece set, and luckily I finished at least figuring out all the ideas that I needed to actually solve it, and I'm gonna do the write-up today. Anyways, as soon as I finished, I made the massive trek back to TD, plopped down on my couch, pulled out some of my military history books, and just did some readings until I fell asleep because I had to get up at 5 a.m. this morning for Air Force PT. Yeah, so it's definitely rough trying to get enough sleep around here because I was in bed, probably fell asleep around 12:30 and had to wake up at 5, but you find ways around it, naps, trying to go to bed early, you know, you eventually figure it out. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I had an amazing time making it. It was a lot of fun to put together, and I love making the day in the life type videos for you guys. Also, I want to emphasize that this was a pretty average weekday at Yale, but I wouldn't say it's an average day at Yale because obviously we have a lot of fun on the weekends and we'd like to have a good time here. And if you don't believe me, go check out some of my other vlogs from the fall or earlier this year. And, the weekdays are a grind, I will say that. So with that, before I close the video, I have a couple questions for you guys. I'm struggling with deciding where exactly I want to take the channel in the next couple months, i.e. do you guys want more magic stuff? Do you guys want more CS related stuff? Do you guys just want more straight vlogs? Like, I'm just trying to figure out which direction I actually want to take the channel and expand a little bit, try out some new things. So definitely let me know down in the comments below. Also let me know what you thought of the video, your favorite parts, which people you want to see back, any tips that you found helpful. Obviously, drop a like down below. It helps me and supports the channel a lot more than you think. And obviously hit that subscribe button because the content is not stopping anytime soon. And I think that like 70% of the people that watch my videos aren't even subscribed, which is wild. So let's try to fix that. So with that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.